Well, I'm Dr. Rob Betcher.
I'm Dr. Michael King.
And we are here to bring you another edition of
Horrible World.
And you know what? We need to know that we went kind of doing something wrong with it. Like, comment, subscribe to anything that you have to say.
Yeah, comment. Like us, subscribe. Right. I mean, Jesus, people, you're watching us repeatedly. Just fucking do it.
Like it. Push the damn button.
Sorry, I get...
I'll hit him for you.
It's a little plus sign, idiots.
This Horrible World story starts with a 9-year-old boy.
This is all about love of family for these two fucking stories.
This family, the uncle comes home and goes, "Hey, what do you have over here?
Oh.
A missing piece of cake."
Hmm.
You piece of shit.
You can't have a birthday with a missing piece of birthday cake.
So he tied his nephew, 9-year-old nephew, to the chair.
9-year-old.
Beat him severely. So,
my favorite cake.
For a piece of cake. And my mother said, "I didn't know what to do. I could have called the ambulance and said, no, he's just having an attack. He has this all the time.
He's got PTSD from a birthday party.
Right, so too much sugar. He's passed out.
Yeah.
So the mother didn't do anything. And the other uncle didn't do anything. He sat by and said, "I feel sorry. I sat back and did nothing.
The kid died from the beating.
And the uncle only got, guess the ticket many, years he got for...
Oh, murdering a 9-year-old, bludgeoning him, which, I mean, that's even harder than just pulling the trigger.
Right.
Gotta be life in sentence.
Oh, you're way off!
Okay, 30 to life.
Getting closer.
25.
Closer. Bring it down.
Way down! 20?
Lower.
Just tell me, please.
10. 10 years.
Jesus.
The kid was 9.
Christ.
And he got 10. So when he got out of prison, the kid would be 19 years old.
They went, "Hey, we're going to give you 1 year longer than the kid was alive."
I could see that mathematically working in their head.
Well, I could see the judge being so stupid and idiotic, he doesn't know what to do but just add one to the age of the victims. So if he would have beaten an 81-year-old, 82 years!
I could see him at the bar right now with the rest of the judges. Didn't feel like I had to do it, but I did it. Tell me this one out. 9-year-old, guy killed him, I had 1 year to his life.
10.
10. Brilliant.
You're a brilliant man.
Cheers to brilliancy.
Cheers!
I can see it happening.
I can see it. You arrogant judges.
Yes. And we're moving on. We have a woman. You know this one, Dr. King.
She's going through a divorce. She's 35, married to a 53-year-old man with a 5-year-old kid. Yeah. Going through a divorce. The husband leaves. She loses her job due to depression.
Oh, no.
Yeah. Loses her apartment because she doesn't have a job.
No!
So she says, "You know what? I'm just going to take care of what caused all this.
Really?
I'm going to make my son, who's 5 years old, take cold medication until he dies."
Yep. It's always taking down the weaker one, huh?
Yep. Hey, took down the Joker.
Yep.
Took down Purple Prince.
Yep.
Took down the King of Pop.
I mean, why not?
It's got to take down a 5-year-old.
Yeah, it's got it.
Then she goes, "Oh, shit. The body. How do I cover this up? I'm going to put him in my car and set the car on fire. And instead of the car, I'm going to have water bottles filled with gasoline because we're going on a road trip."
Yeah, and never know when we run out of gas.
Oops, I lit my cigarette, it caught on fire, and somehow I closed the car and it was locked and I couldn't get into my son.
Wait, wait, wait. She was smoking?
Yep.
Isn't it, if MTV is trying to make 8% of this generation?
Oh, it's the last generation.
Thanks, Team Mom.
My name's Caitlin, I'm fat. I hate myself.
Can't have babies, I can't be recognized. That's right, that's you, MTV, call out.
I hate you.
It's a horrible world.
You're just living in it.